What is photography? Photography is a technique that allows the capture of the picture with light. Is photography an art? I believe it is, just like painting, music or poetry, but at the same time, it doesn't have to be an art. Photography is an art when it's telling a story and it influences the viewer. Is it bad that today people switch to digital media to create photographs? No. I don't think there is something like bad technique. It can only be badly chosen or executed. Why gum dichromate? Kodak had a phrase for this. Push the button and we will do the rest. Gum dichromate is based on the phrase, push the button and think how to do the rest ourselves. It's a technique that gives the artist freedom to interpret the picture all by himself. The creator decides about everything and is able to create a unique phrase to the photo. In the 19th century, the scientists noticed that Egyptian papyrus did not change the color for over 4,000 years. They examined them and found out that it was thanks to the mixture of acacia gum and soot. At the same time, someone else noticed that training of animal leathers in the sodium dichromate happens twice as fast when it is exposed to sunlight. It's not only really clear who connected those two facts and mixed acacia gum with the pigment and sodium dichromate. Then he painted the paper with it, put a negative on top and exposed it on sunlight, then he rinsed it in clear water. But that how the gum dichromate technique was created. The process, which are the ingredients, are Arabic gum, acacia gum, dissolved in water. Potassium dichromate or sodium dichromate that is light sensitive when mixed with colloid dissolved in water. Natural pigment. Good quality paper that is acid free. The layer preparation. Put the pigment, Arabic gum and dichromate into the mixing bowl and mix carefully. When there is no pigment lumps visible, the mix is then ready. Now, spread the pigment with wide flat brush on the paper. The thinner the layer, the better the surface. Dry the paper and remember after 24 hours the paper is not light sensitive anymore. Layer isn't very light sensitive, so you can't use the enlarger with this. You should use big negative and place it straight onto the paper, then leave it on the sun. The times vary from 2 minutes to a couple of hours depending on the sunshine. Sunlight exposure. The beauty of the sunlight is the fact that it changes differently in the morning than it does in the evening. That's why every dichromate gum artist is measuring the exposure time with heartbeats, as the master, Diderco, used to say. After the exposure, put it in a tray with the water to rinse the pigment. After that, dries the print. When the photo is dry, repeat the process and change the proportions of gum and dichromate depending on the effect that you want to achieve. There is no exact recipe for this. How to create a decent gum, and it's a very personal and individual technique which is unique to the artists themselves. This isn't a technique that you can use as a machine would. All steps have to be done all by hand. There is no two identical works as artists, and this is a situation that the human is always in constant change and in charge of this technique themselves. Chemical parameters are never the same. There aren't two identical drops of Arabic gum, nor natural pigment. I know that Arabic gum and dichromic is a niche technique, and that digital photography will become even stronger, but it's a technique that will give us a lot of satisfaction, so we need to save it from being forgotten. Thank you very much.